this is actually the aspect of come of the study. We have the ASEAN CBCA in the middle. The strategy if we look at regulation, policy, strategy, knowledge-based system and tools and funding and financing that might be needed in order to adopt the CBCA in ASEAN. We then try to find what kind of capacity is needed and the resilience target as the part of the ASEAN CBCA. So the key features is how to engage with new investment. On what? Technology, behavior, institutional data. Because data can come from everywhere, but what kind of data that we can believe on, that we can use together, and then the benefit and the impacts. The main result is clear: emission reduction and adaptation option. Because when you're talking about climate change, there is always across the nation how we do low carbon society. What is the strategy to reduce the emission, and then how we adapt with the new changing climate. Is adaptation options, what we do with the new climate arena. And the guideline for this one, we try to use the stakeholder participation, coordination and integration, no one left behind, local wisdom. So what happened in country, from country to country in ASEAN, we also look at it about the local wisdom and lesson learned from previous program in this country. So we read many articles, papers, and everything across the 10 countries in ASEAN because Timor-Leste is still observing here, but we still also look at what's going on there. And we try to find the generality that we can propose, and also we try to still hold the uniqueness of this country because maybe this is only you guys can do it, for example. And how you then start to cooperate. We know the new climate arena now, that is maybe if you know some funding vehicle in climate change, there is a green climate funds, they're really stripped down. You only can tap in the fund when you have the country strategy articulated in your document. What is the country document? NDC. And luckily, all the member states have the NDC. So that's actually our main sources in the beginning to see how the CBCA can be. In. Because for example, like Singapore, because the country size and everything, maybe the CBCA who may occur in Indonesia or the Philippines is not might not possible if S is there, but there is might be some community participation or community engagement. That actually the essence how we conduct the study. Next slide. So this is look more complicated. To try this operationalize the ASEAN CBCA, we have the assessment report as the result, technical guideline. So maybe each country have some generic strategy. If they want to conduct community-based action, what kind of essential element that they need to follow in, we will produce technical guidance. And the policy brief. This is maybe for all of you guys at AWGJ working group. Because we know the technical assessment usually quite thick. Who wants to read the thick book now? Not many people want to read the thick one. And if you want to speak with your decision maker, etc., etc., that's why we also created the policy brief with the CCA and NDC, the focus community, and strategy to addressing gaps and needs. So how we do this is on the left-hand side. We learn the county group. Baseline information from the first workshop, and then we strive to have the strategy for action is also baseline information from the first workshop. We have these three group indicators. The scale, so the country is divided into size, population, and the governance. So how your government do is politics, something like that. And then the economy, we look at the quite macro indicator, GDP, SDI, Gini, tax, country debt, and environmental sustainability, global climate risk index, and SDGs. So that's how we try to cluster the country. And then the regulation, indeed, and in the country level, and participation of the community. So there are three strategies, critical strategies for the country and participation. We need encouragement. In a sense, is acknowledgement. How country to country acknowledge what is done by the community. Usually, most the action are strived by the donors. There is a project. So how this can be escalate or upscale country size? This is what we mean by encouragement. And then, if it's already in your regulation, must be goes with endorsement. Because you can endorse this. For example, in Indonesia, we have a climate village program named PROCLIM. This is already in Indonesian government regulation. So they endorse the community to do it. Usually when you say endorse, there is some tactical strategy there. We don't have adequate financial capacity, right? That's why you do endorsement. This is just a strategy. When you have everything, for example, like Singapore, it's government control. This is the same in other countries. And then if it's coming from the participation of the community to ASEAN CPCA, we name it the strategy is empowerment. Because the community actually have some kind of capacity. Usually we think they cannot do, actually they do a lot. We just need to empower. How to make it personal? This is the empower, just need some incentive or some acknowledgement, something like that. That actually we try to strip in ASEAN CBCA to have these three output. So these two slide actually the essence how this study is conducted. The other slide is just the result. So maybe for those who are, of you who are coming from the government side, these two slide that you really need to look at carefully, because all the titles there, the words they are we are using, sometimes quite sensitive maybe in your country, and you might need some translation or changing word or something like that. Because sometimes in bureaucracy, the choice of words is very important, right? If we misspell some word, it might have multi implication. Okay, next slide. So this is just the workflows mechanism, how we conducted this. January, February, we do review analysis. March to June, we consultation with you guys, sometimes through FGD, through communication, via email, etc. And we are very thankful.